The MACPro Help Desk team welcomes your suggestions for our training and reference materials. Please contact us with your feedback and comments on this training, or if you need other MACPro assistance. You may contact us via email at macpro_helpdesk@cms.hhs.gov or by phone at 301-547-4688.
Now that you have an understanding of MACPro, let's take a look at the Federal Fiscal Year 2019 MACPro System Updates for Quality Measures Reporting. Here we'll talk about system-specific changes and updates for adult, child, health home quality measures. There are a few changes that are across all authorities in quality measures reporting, and some that are specific to each core set. For all quality measures in 2019, instructions have been updated under the Delivery System section on the admin screen. Instructions have also been added below the Performance Measure section and Data Source section within applicable core measures. These updates to the instructions were to improve data quality. They are not a change from previous guidance. The numerator field within the Performance Measure, Other Performance Measure, and Optional Measure Stratification section of all applicable core measures has been updated to allow states to enter 0 in the numerator field and still be able to manually enter a weighted rate for measures reported using hybrid alone or both administrative and hybrid data sources. Additionally, further instructions were added to the Performance Measure section to provide guidance on what to report in the denominator field and in the Additional Notes and Comments section. Instructions were added to encourage users to explain large increases or decreases to the rate or measure eligible population. Instructions were also updated in the date range section of all applicable core set measures. Now we will look at the changes specific to each core set measure. For adult quality measures reports in 2019, instructions were updated in the definition of population section for all core set measures except CPA-AD. As a note, this is not a specification change, rather instructions to help your state ensure data quality. Data sources were also added and removed on the core set measures listed on the slide. Additionally, the data labels were updated on tables in the Performance Measure section in the PCR-AD core set measure. For child quality measures reports in 2019, there were changes in data sources in the core set measure on the slide, and text was also added in the Performance Measure section in the W15CH core set measure. These are instructions to improve data quality and not technical specification changes. For health and quality measures reports in 2019, the text was updated below the definition of population section for all core, utilization, and state-specific measures, and data sources were added and removed on the core set measures listed on the slide. Lastly, the data labels were updated on tables in the Performance Measure section in the PCR and IU core set measures listed on this slide. We're coming close to the top of the hour, and we want to allow enough time to answer your questions, so we're going to skip the tips and tricks section. However, please keep these handy as you use MACPro in the future. Let's go over some additional resources available to users to help guide you while using MACPro. The pre-recorded modules linked on the slide walk through the quality measures reporting submission process step-by-step in MACPro. The first module shows how a state editor creates a report, edits a core measure, and submits a report to the state point of contact. In the second module, the SBOC reviews a report, sends the report to the state director, and the state director reviews and certifies the report to send to CMS. The last module shows how a SBOC and a state editor answer an SMI request and update the report accordingly. Users can find additional MACPro resources on Medicaid.gov. The links on this slide lead to several helpful instructions and reference documents. In addition to using the resources available on Medicaid.gov, you may want to contact the MACPro Help Desk. For issues related to MACPro access or the MACPro system, you can reach the Help Desk via email at macpro_helpdesk@cms.hhs.gov or via phone at 301-547-4688. The Help Desk is available Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Let's talk about next steps. As we mentioned at the start of our training, Quality Measures for Federal Fiscal Year 2019 is now available in MACPro. If you do not already have an EIDM ID or MACPro access, we recommend that you do that soon. Instructions providing an overview to gaining access to MACPro through the CMS Enterprise Portal are located on Medicaid.gov via the links on this slide. And as a final reminder, the reporting deadline is December 31st, 2019.
The MACPro Help Desk team welcomes your suggestions for our training and reference materials. Please contact us with your feedback and comments on this training, or if you need other MACPro assistance. You may contact us via email at macpro_helpdesk@cms.hhs.gov or by phone at 301-547-4688.